Skippy the Third, he's dead! I'm a freaking pig! A pig killed this guy! What the hell is going on in this kingdom of crazy freaking animals? Oh, I'm getting freaking flying pigs! There's literally flying pigs in this game, guys! And they're kicking my ass six ways of Sunday! Oh, why are there flying pigs? Hello once again from the Tokyo jungle, my Jade Warriors. Isaac here, and you're back with me staring at the Tokyo skyline. Yes, very possibly from the top of the Tokyo Skytree. Do you guys know the Tokyo Skytree? It's the new tallest building in Japan. It's just a little bit shy of the same height as the tower in Dubai. Still freaking tall though, an amazing view from the top. I'll try and get some footage and stick it on the channel sometime in the future so you guys can check it out. It's pretty damn cool. But anyway, I digress. Thank you very much for tuning in for another episode of Tokyo Jungle, guys. If you watched the last episode, you would realize that we got started with the very first story episode of the game. It was interesting. It was fun. A little Panoramian, learning to deal with the world as it is today. But anyway, today we're going to be jumping back into the survival mode. We got our ass handed to us at the end of the last episode as a gazelle, and that will not stand. No, we're going to take the action back to survival mode, and we're going to totally pawn it by playing a herbivore. But instead of playing the gazelle, which we did last episode, I was keen to get back in with the gazelle and, totally pawn it this time around. But this week, DLC patch just came out, and you wouldn't believe what is now available. Oh yeah, baby, we got the panda bear. We're still doing a panda bear playthrough in the near future. We got ourselves the giraffe, the crocodile, but most importantly, the kangaroo! Oh yeah, it's time for me to embrace my Australian heritage like never before on the channel and play myself a kangaroo. So let's get started! Oh, this is going to be fun, guys. I've really been looking forward to playing the kangaroo. Of course, as you guys know, there's a lot of kangaroos in Australia, and they are very vicious predators. They often, trap and hunt humans like raptors from Jurassic Park. If you remember your history, in 1986, there was a huge assault on Sydney by 20,000 kangaroos, and a lot of humans were killed, eaten, and pretty much cannibalized by the kangaroos. So, I am a little bit angry with the kangaroos myself, but forgive and forget. Hey guys, forgive and forget. I'll just take a little bit of anger out on this buddy. Clean kill. Of course I'm lying, guys. Of course kangaroos aren't freaking predators and carnivores. No, they're adorable little sods that like to eat grass and just give out free hugs. Yeah, I love kangaroos. Of course they're adorable. And to tell the truth, this time telling the truth, I often ride them to work. They are an incredibly, convenient form of transportation. And yeah, a lot faster than most small vehicles. So yeah, kangaroos are pretty awesome. Very, very convenient source of transportation. I got you again! I got you again, didn't I? That's another lie. I'm sorry. Please don't follow my example, guys. Lying is bad. All right, fingers crossed. No, not fingers crossed, but cross my heart, hope to die. From now on, I'm going to tell the truth. So, in all reality, near my parents' house in Australia, my parents have quite a lot of land available near their house, and right next to my parents' house lives a family of kangaroos. See, cross my heart, hope to die, it's the truth. Scouts on her, dib, 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 dob, dob, dob. But, a family of kangaroos used to live on the lawn next to my parents' place. And they're absolutely adorable, guys. They're so charming and sweet. Yeah, but of course, you shouldn't approach them. They're not vicious animals, but they don't take, kindly to being approached undesirably. You know, they just want to chill out and relax and rest with their family. Enjoy life without humans, trying to give out free hugs on them. So, Anyway, let's see the challenge list for today. Let's see what's available. Mark 6 times. Got to do it 3 more times. Change generations once. And claim the cat territory. Okay, they are in the Shibuya suburbs. Oh my god. That's a little far away. And they're cats. Now, I know a kangaroo is nice, big, and strong, but cats, especially if they're swarming our little hoppy friend here, it could be a problem. It could definitely be a problem. So, before I forget, I should definitely equip myself a couple of items. Let's see here. Might put on something, yeah, like an antenna. Of course, that suits a kangaroo's style down to the T, doesn't it, guys? A girl's school scarf, because we've got ourselves a cross-dressing kangaroo, apparently. A bikini that belongs to Borat on our tranny kangaroo. And to top it off, he's going to be barefoot. Because in all honesty, like, there's probably not many shoes that are going to fit his giant feet. Oh my god, this is crazy. Look at our little guy. We've got ourselves a tranny kangaroo. Oh my god, I feel sorry for the little guy. I'm sorry. We're going to name him Skippy, guys. Skippy, because if any of you guys know your Australian TV history, which I wouldn't be surprised if you don't, it's that the most famous kangaroo in Australia is Skippy the kangaroo. Oh, there's some grass around here, and a dead end, apparently. Oh, there you go. There's the entrance to something, but I can't enter it as the kangaroo, apparently. Got ourselves a sheep. I'm guessing that blue dot is just the bed. All right. So we'll have to remember that bed is in that little alcove there, that dead end. But yeah, going back to Skippy. Yeah, in the 1970s and 80s, I believe. Very famous TV show called Skippy, about a kangaroo that was owned by a family of animal caretakers. And yeah, he often helped them, kind of like Lassie did in any of those, you know, Lassie series from America. The good old dog assisting her human masters. Skippy was exactly the same. Just for Australians. So of course everyone had very strong Australian accents. It was fantastic. I loved it. Loved it to tears. I miss Skippy. So I'm glad. I'm glad he's back and hopping his way through Shibuya. Which of course makes perfect sense. Alright, we've marked ourselves 6 times, but I'm just on the search for food because we're now getting hungry here, guys. We're getting hungry. There's only sheep here. We're not predators. We can't eat the meat. I need myself a garden fresh salad. Maybe a little bit of tomato. Oh, you're a prime female. Can you come with me? Not yet. Oh, fine. I've got to impress her. But everyone, remember where that prime female is. Because she's awesome. Holy crap, that's a lot of cats. That's a lot of cats. Oh my god. I need to eat before I die. I don't want to die yet. All right, there we go. Finally got some food. We leveled up. Oh, and we're dodging freaking cat attacks left and right, guys. Holy crap. Oh my god, they're onto me. They're onto me. They can tell that I'm not fitting in with the rest of this fiend line crowd. Quickly, eat your vegetarian steak, by which I mean flowers, my kangaroo buddy. Oh, we got ourselves another archive note as well. Sweet. Let's just take a quick timeout. Timeout, kiddies! Timeout! Oh! I said timeout, you lousy bastard! Ah! And let's have a quick look at this archival note. Alright, newspaper article. Zookeeper critically injured. About 7:30 a.m. on March 14th, a worker at the zoo in Tokyo was attacked and critically injured by a bear. According to police, he suffered bites to his face and arms and was still unconscious.
How do I scroll down again? Oh, that's the entirety of the message? Okay, there we go. Don't need to scroll down.
Staff at the zoo say animals are behaving strangely. Police are investigating the zoo's safety procedures along with any possible connection to other animal-related incidents in the vicinity recently.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I think I said either last episode or over the last few episodes, several different possibilities for this human apocalypse, but it seems like one of them might have been right on the ball. It seems that, whoa! The animals might have gone crazy and eaten all of the humans. Shit, no time to sit down and munch on some grass right now. Just gotta keep moving. Lucky the... Whoa, how do we get through here? Whoa, freaking... cat attacks! I don't want to get eaten! Holy crap, I'm being swarmed by cats! Oh my god! I guess the cats of this game's aliens? They're just gonna kick my ass at this rate. Ooh, another archival note. Man, someone went to the effort of wrapping them all up nicely and laying them out for our good old kangaroo mate here. Oh, that's right. I remember now. Oh, I have to mark the area. Oh, no, you don't. No, you don't. You don't kill me. Not right now. Holy crap. Okay. Some of my items just broke, I think. They certainly did. Apparently being swarmed by cats was enough to shake our kangaroo out of his transvestite state into a more preppy style individual. Oh my god, this is getting a bit scary. I think we need to call on the Demon Lord. Will the Demon Lord do it for us? Or our... Ah, there we go. How... Mannequin! Oh my god, look at that. That's adorable. Like a little human. Little human riding our kangaroo, mate. Oh, come on, get your life back! No! Oh! Stupid cat swarm! Frickin', they're the aliens of the frickin' animal kingdom, apparently. Bloody bastards, jumping on my face and trying to rip the crap out of me. Ah, you suck, kitties. Holy crap, I was not expecting that. I should not have been so nonchalantly jumping my way around the cat district. That was not the way to go, no. But I thought, you know, my kangaroo buttocks were thick enough to endure a little bit of that, but apparently not. Alright, let's try that again. I'm still getting used to playing these herbivores because, like I said before, like they are a completely different game style to the predators. Like you are playing a lot more aggressively, a lot more, you know, in your face with the predators. The herbivores completely change the style of the game. Alright, so let's go straight into the challenge list, check what we've got. Much, much easier a challenge list than last time. But, I like that last challenge list. That was fun. Alright, and the final unlock. No animal unlocks, unfortunately. But there is complete all challenges. So, and for a tuxedo. So, if we want to look at ourselves like James Bond and acquire a pair of boxing gloves, which would be freaking sweet, we have to get started by heading to Doginzaka, then Yoyogi Park East, and then find the giant tuna. I do believe I saw that once before in the Shibuya suburbs. Interesting indeed. So yes, let's get started by heading towards Yoyogi Park. So. Yeah, sorry guys, sorry about that. I seem to do that a lot with these, survival playthroughs, don't I, guys? I sort of suck balls for the first 10 minutes, die rather quickly, and then the second playthrough is quite considerably long. So, we've got to respect and live up to that tradition, I think, guys. We need to make sure that this is, respectably long playthrough. Gotta make sure we last this time for at least 50 minutes. We've got to outdo the length of our Silky Terrier playthrough and have a hell of a lot of fun doing it in the process. So, Doginzaka, we're already here.
We're in Dogenthaka, but nobody's here. What should we do? We should piddle here and munch on some grass right next to my toilet.
Yeah. I guess kangaroos have much lower standards than us humans. They don't mind eating where they pee. Present! What you got for me? Archival notes? No! Discounted pet food! Lucky it's discounted. I didn't actually have much cash on me, to tell the truth. Hang on! Kangaroos aren't supposed to have any cash on them! Fucking get lost, you stupid dogs! Alright, that's it. You freaking brought this on yourself! Ugh. See, I should've just been doing that in the cats' faces. I should've just laid into them with a left and a right instead of letting them swarm me like that. But I didn't think it would go down like that, guys. I'm telling you the truth. Freaking cat armies everywhere. Oh, let's hope that don't happen again. But looking at the challenge list, I didn't see any claim territory requirements this time around. So. Should all be good. Come here, stupid beagle. You and your family seem to have something against me and my family, so bring it on. Well, buffalo, you're nice, right? You're a herbivore? Yeah, you're a herbivore. Give me some skin, son. Mm-hmm. Give me some tail. Yeah, give me some tails. Yeah, we're two of the same. We're bros. Yo, we're bros of the animal kingdom, yo, man. Yeah, he's my man. He's my bud. Mr. Buffalo. Alright. Come on, Skippy. Don't put this reincarnation of yourself to waste. Get yourself a wool beanie on, a master choker, and a pad pack? Oh, there you go. He's ready to go to school. Now, I think the reason we had ourselves some bad luck last time is because we didn't have... Look at all these guys. We didn't have ourselves Toro equipped, but... Oh, we can't use Toro. He's our good luck kitty. God damn it. Fine, let's get ourselves... I think we'll go with that. A cozy sweater would be nice, but I'm going to go with the pet pack. So, in case we run out of food, we can start eating our bento lunch that's tucked away in the back there. Why aren't you eating your tomatoes? Come on, Skippy. Come on, Skip. Skippy, eat the plant, man. It's right in front of you. Stupid bird. Fine. How about this? There you go. Apparently, this incarnation of Skippy is one picky bastard. He only likes the best of the best of the best. Whoa, I see that tiger hiding there. He's still facing the other way. Shit. He saw me. But, go away, tiger. You're not having this, booty. Nah, you're not getting any call from this booty. No booty call for you. But presents for me. Maybe that tiger's the one laying all those presents out. Yeah, he's laying all those presents out so that people like me, animals like me, let my guard down. I'm so happy and surprised to be getting a present left for me. And then suddenly, no, I die instead. I don't get a present. Not a nice surprise. I get a bad surprise. I get killed, which is not fun. What do you want, kitty? I'm not... I'm not giving you what's in my backpack. No, kitty. This is not for you. This backpack is not for you. Bad kitty. Honestly, what possessed you? Look at me. I'm 5 times the size of you. And you wanted to pick a fight? You silly pussy. There was no brains in that pussy. Whoa, holy crap. There's a lot of dangerous animals around here. Just another quick... I've got to defeat animals. 6 more. Just another quick challenge check there. Another quick present unwrap. And another quick... I'm sorry. I hate to kill my own kind. To bully my own species. My own faction. But... I need to defeat some more animals. I'm sorry, little guys. I feel really bad, but trust me, your death will not have been in vain. Your death will assist me. Your sacrifice will help not only me, but all Jade Warriors actually enjoy this playthrough. Holy crap, what was that? I heard something. There's some predator around here. All right. I may have killed a couple of predators just now, but it's time for me to take the fight to the carnivores. Yeah, how do you like that? All right, you two. Don't mess with Australia or a kangaroo. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Represent. Yeah. You don't mess with Australia. Australia messes with you, son. Mm-hmm. What? Oh! Bring it, little man. Jackal. Yeah, bet you're wishing you had your Mr. Hyde here right about now. Whoa. Well, shit, I'm getting surrounded. Come on, guy. Oh, you missed. Oh. Beat 10 animals. And how? I'm not going to stop there. Taking the fight to these bastards. Come on. Oh, shit. No. We're not going to die. Oh, my God. No, Skip. Come on, Skip. Get that caution rating down. Quick, get in some grass. Hide yourself in some grass. There we go. Oh, my God. That was not good. Luckily, we got some food up on the rooftop in front of us. And the caution rating's just about gone. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. There we go. All right, let's get ourselves this. Ah, little bit of vegetables. Sustenance. That's laying here for us. Oh, that was a close call, gang. Can we go over here? No. Hang on, wasn't there a path there when I was playing some of the other animals? Ah, maybe they remove certain pathways for the kangaroo or larger herbivores and carnivores. That seems to be the shtick for this game. Alright. Oh, come on, bring it. Sick of you guys freaking harassing me. Come on! Oh, sorry, Bambi! Sorry! Oh, shit. Sorry, I'll put you out of your misery. Oh, I'm a bastard. Sorry about that. Wow. Oh. Here I am, killing Disney's backlog of characters. Oh, well. Can't stop there. Any Dalmatians around? Any Dalmatians I can kick the ass off in these times? Oh! There you go, apparently that present. Oh, and here's another one, a peace offering from the Dalmatians. They want to appease me so I don't hunt them down and kick their ass. Ah, you freaking jackals. I hate you. You're going down right now. There we go. Oh, I can see a present over there in the distance. You leave those deer alone. Only I can freaking harass the deer, you freaking jackal. Alright, what do we got to do? I think change generations one time. No, just keep marking. Okay, we're doing good. We're doing real good. And then just head on over to Yogi Park East. Yay! And by the looks of it, if we zoom out, Yogi Park East is where we want to be because there's an event going down and there seems to be a decent amount of food available. So, let's do it. Let's keep moving. There we go. All right, new turn. Keep your claws to yourself. At least have the decency to sterilize them first, you frickin' hyena. Hey, you ain't so strong now, are ya? Huh? When you're dead. Can't imagine many animals are strong, though, when they're dead. Yeah, there's one. Wow, there's many a kind of wolf in this zone, apparently. Damn, there's a lot of wolves around here. Alright, one more marking, one more piddle to make sure our prostate is in working order and we shall be rewarded for it. Yay! Holy crap, there's another present! Hell yeah, yes please! Thank you! Pet medicine! Should I catch the pet AIDS? Which I hope I don't. Alright. If I remember correctly as well, there was a present just over here. Can't go that way. Shit, there really is a lot of pathways removed for the larger animals, it seems. You. Oh, I hate you. Yeah! Wake you up in the middle of a nice, sexy hyena dream. Hey, there you were dreaming about Miss September from the hyena catalog and went and ruined that for you. Yeah. Because you're dead. Alright, scuff down there, son. Bit of grass. Alright, beautiful. So, let's keep on heading to Yoyogi Park East because, damn! Oh, that was... Oh, porcupine! Sorry, Mr. Porcupine! I'm sorry, that was horrible of me. Oops, I thought you were like a small predatorial dog of some kind, a new species that had needles sticking out of his back, but no. I'm just a complete noob and don't know what the hell's a dog from a cat and a porcupine from a freaking raptor. Oh, no you don't. Gotta do a 5,000% more dodging of these bastards. Gotta evade like a boss. Alright, there we go guys. The first set of challenges has been completed. We can say hello to Mr. Hippo here. Mr. Hippo, sorry, can you move your fat ass, please? I wanted to eat the flowers. Can you get your crutch? Stop rubbing your junk on my dinner. Please stop rubbing your junk on my dinner. Ah. Now that's one impolite hippopotamus right there. Smart ass. Or dirty ass, I should say. Just wiping it on my freaking lunch. All right, I'm just going to wait about 10 seconds until we hit year 11 so we can start eating all the local vegetation to reach our 2,500 calories goal. Because there's not... There we go. 2,500 calories. Sweet. Because there's not going to be that much food on the Yamanote train line. Oh, Mr. Hippo. Yuck. Oh, you really marinated those flowers, didn't you, in your freaking junk, bastard. Next time, just, you know, use toilet paper like the rest of civilized society. Bastard. Oh, hello, Mr. Monkey. How you going? I'm not going to kill you. You have a big job ahead of you. You've got to repopulate this entire freaking planet. At least until the next time we animals go batshit crazy and start eating all of you. I wonder what really went down. Hey guys, something strange, something funky. I should mark that point just here. Seeing as I'm here, might as well put it to good use. There we go. Because it's probably going to be 2 or 3 years before my next toilet break. Lol. What the hell is going on with the time in this game? Something peculiar, I'm telling you. Oh, I can't ride the train. That's freaking racist, that is. Why? Why can't I? Oh, whoa, oh, lion cub. Oh, shit. That was probably a bad idea. I can't imagine lions are going to take very kindly to me killing their offspring. Uh-oh. Nothing in the grass in front of me? Okay. Mark it, man. Remember, we've been here. We don't get lost. Uh-oh, just check the grass. Gotta remember to check the grass. Because pretty much every time I've died playing a herbivore so far in previous episodes was from something jumping at me from out of the grass. Usually a beagle. I hate those dogs. They're bastards. Alright, let's keep moving here. We're going to have to be careful as well. If you guys can see the hunger bar, it's been currently at 33 or 33, which is awesome. But once you reach a certain age, I don't know if it depends on the animal you're playing or not, but the hunger bar, the max limit of the hunger bar will quickly start declining because pretty much of your age, because you're getting freaking old. You just don't have the stamina to get up and go you did when you were a child, so. Well, careful. Animal in the grass, I saw that. Ah, crap. Did it want to kill me? No, we're good. No caution rating. All right, that's good stuff. Yay! Oh, and there's a female down here. Just gonna put it. Run back here. I saw something in the grass here, didn't I? But it's a deer. I can see the horns. Yay! We got ourselves a nice, clean female. She's only average. She's the average kind of female, but she'll do. Ah, crap! The frickin' lair's a fair way back, isn't it? And we've really got to get to Yoyogi Park East. I think we're gonna keep her around. We're gonna mark the next area and hopefully get ourselves a lair that is much, much closer one to the final piddle point. Watch the grass, guys. Make sure you tell me, guys, if you see anything lurking in the grass. So probably by the time you email me, by the time I check my email and read it and respond, it'll probably be too late. Imagine it'll be too late. But at least you guys tried. It's the thought that counts. It really is. It's the thought that counts. Man, this is one messed up world. Hey, all the higher species are forcing me to ride on top of the train. That's freaking racist right there. Woo-hoo! Which I needed desperately. Alright, so I've got to be very, very careful in the dark because I'm sure you guys realize that the animals disappear from the mini-map in the bottom left-hand corner as soon as it's dark. But there we go, now it's daytime. Yay! Let's hope we can get through the day. Oh man, the piddle point's down below us! Oh, that's not fair! That's cheating! Freaking game's cheating! It's forced. Ah, man. That's what you get for taking the high road in this game, apparently. Alright, we're running out of years. We've got 5 years left, and we've still got a considerable distance to cross. And now, apparently, there's poisonous clouds all over the freaking shop. So, let's just grab this present and start freaking tailing it to your Yogi Park. Because, yeah. Even though I'm sure a few people enjoy getting high on poisonous fumes, I'm certainly not one of that crowd. So, finish your food, Skippy. Come on, boy. Don't waste food like that. Gotta eat all your greens. How about you guys? Did you guys have parents that were always like, you gotta eat all your greens? Don't waste your greens. Eat everything. I know mine did. And they were good to do so. Any responsible parent would tell their children to eat their vegetables. Because you gotta grow up big and strong, guys. Like, seriously. Holy crap, I just realized my toxicity was at 96. Holy crap. That was a close call. Let's hope that poisonous smog doesn't spread to Yogi Park West immediately in any kind of a hurry. Alright, there we go. We've got some more water there, but we're full hell hunger, so we don't need to use that right now. And if we keep heading in this direction, we should hit this wolf in the face! Son of... Oh, he's more quick! Gotta stop him calling his mates in. So yeah, I don't know if I've said before, but if a wolf has that little circle above their head that is slowly counting down, if that completes a full 360-degree rotation, they will actually call in reinforcements, call in their posse to assist them. So you really got to make sure you call out those animals that are calling in their mates first before anything else. Oh, look at that. Fresh veggies. They're totally reducing my toxicity. Sweet. And we've still got 3 years left to reach your Yogi Park East, which we are just about to do as soon as we cross this bridge. There's no bridge there. There you go. Another thing that was changed. What the hell is that? That looks like a predator just lounging around there in the park. I don't want to get too close and friendly with that guy. All right, here we go. Oh, shit, lion. Let's sneak past him quietly. Don't wake him. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, he woke up. Oh, god damn it. Crap. We're in trouble. We're in big trouble. But we made it to Yogi Park East. Hang on. No cautionary gauge is up and working. So maybe the lion he didn't see. No, he's attacking the wolves. Yeah, you guys keep that up. Go, I'm betting on you, lion. I'm betting on you to win that freaking round. Oh, sweet. We did it, guys. Oh, we freaking did it. All we've got to do is make it to that piddle point. Hopefully without alerting that cat who's now awake. Come on, just quietly. If we can piddle, we can make a new generation in the lair of this zone because our hunger is at 13. Yes, where's the lair? I don't even know where the lair is. I have never, oh look, Oh, you're a female, but I've already got my average female following me. All right, come on, move it. Our life is running out here. Is there any plants? Very, very close. We've got that pool of water. Thank God we didn't use it. Hey, oh, too post hastily. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Ah, oh, that's the best freaking glass of water I've ever enjoyed in my life. Ah, oh, yay. Well done, gang. We freaking did it. Oh, shit. Did we eat enough calories? Yes, we did it. Yeah. We freaking did it. We pawned the D-level challenges. Oh, yeah, guys, that's what I'm talking about. So we have to change generations 2 times in the next challenge list, which is from 21 years old. So I'm going to see if I can actually just hang out for another year before getting down and funky with our average female. The female we settled for. Yeah, we looked at how our life was going. Oh, I can't go through this huge-ass cave here. Man. Yeah, we looked at how our life was going. Where we stood in our life, how things were progressing with our career and relationships, and we went, hell, we'll settle for our average female friend. And you know, we're pretty happy. We're happy that we settled. Fill up that hunger. Come on, you can do it, Skip. You only gotta live for one more year, boy. You can do it. Is there any food around here I can gnaw on? Damn, look at my hunger gauge. It's at freaking 5. Oh, shit. Ah, shit. 20 years old. I'm dying. I'm literally slowly dying. Crap. Quick. Kill the lion cub. Ah. Oh, my God. I'm literally slowly dying. We're not going to see to the end of the year. Oh, we're not going to make it, guys. Oh, fine. Let's have sex. Ah. Man, I was trying to put it off as long as possible. Hoping, you know, like a fine wine, you average female would get better with age, but I guess that was just not the case. Crap, that means we're gonna have sex. We're gonna have babies twice in 10 years. Holy shit. Oh my God, I don't even know if that's gonna be possible. God damn it, why couldn't we hang out? Just hang on for one more year? Isn't the Medicare of the animal kingdom any good? God damn it. Shit, this is gonna be a problem. All right, let's see if we can. Doshio, what are we gonna do? All right, let's check the map, see where all the food is. Oh my God, there's like no food south of Dolgenzaka. There's only a little bit in Yamanote Line East, and apparently there's a young upstart that is making its home there right now. Ah, shit. Alright, let's see what we can do. Looks like we're just gonna have to settle with some dirty females that don't care if we're untrained and very, very young females. Not enough space in my item bag, seriously? Are you kidding me, right? Shit, maybe I should have used up some of my items. Holy crap. Oh, that backpack on my back! There you go, it's given me another 5 slots to fill. Sweet! I should have eaten the hearty chicken breast, then I would have lived for longer in the last generation. Halt stamina loss for a little while. Fills hunger gauge and reduces toxicity. Flea shampoo. We'll take the stamina fella, so we can get moving. Because we're gonna get laid in a hurry, guys. Right, 1 year's already passed. And we're not laid yet. I might be setting my expectations just a little bit high. Yeah. But I tell you, the youth of today, they're in such a hurry to grow up. Aren't you, Skippy Jr.? Hey, you're just in a hurry to be a man kangaroo. But you know, you've got that gnawing feeling that you should be a tranny. You know, it's in your bloodline from one of your previous incarnations. All right, come on. All right, we're getting poisoned here. There's apparently no food in the local area. And all the females are up the other end of the tracks. What do we got here? Is there any food in Yoyogi Park West? No. Bad. not good, not good. I don't like it, guys. We're in trouble. But thankfully, there's some food over here. Check the grass, nothing. Waiting to gnaw our bollocks off. Nah, we're good. Some veggies. Fantastic. Alright. Keep on moving to the next little point. As long as we can get laid twice in 10 years, I think we're good, because the rest is just defeat some animals and find the giant tuna. Shit, isn't the giant tuna... Oh my god, one moment, guys. I think I need to quickly check the net for item locations. There's actually a Japanese map online that has everything listed. But it's all written in Japanese, which is a little bit of a problem. But, just checking the map. Holy shit, I think the, the giant tuna is in the Shibuya suburbs down the other end of the map. My god, game, give me a break, are you serious? I like the idea of randomized challenges, but holy crap, they're a freaking bitch sometimes. We're just gonna have to hot-tail it to the other end of the freaking map and try and score some bootai on the way. Look out, watch the grass. That's just the deer, alright. Oh man, that sucks. Why tuna? Why can't you be swimming here in this pool of water so close to our last objective? Damn you to hell. Holy shit, we're nearly at 5 years. This is really bad. Just wait, let me check. Sorry, I keep jumping into the challenges. We've got until 30 years, yeah. Shit. Because after 30 years, you have 15 years to complete challenges, which is nice, but... Oh, poison food. Shit. Any dirty females close to home here? Any dirty females real close? Anyone with low standards standing right next to me? Oh, boss! Shit! Freaking Lion Club boss! Oh, you're the young upstart that the freaking event log was talking about. Yeah, I'll freaking show you. Come on, guys. Get in there! Yeah! I'm the boss of you! And yeah, you'll do, dirty female. Come on. We've got no choice but to get down and funky. We're running out of time! Get yourself over here! Present yourself! You dirty, dirty girl. You only get $10 out of me! And that's it. Crap. I've got a lot less brethren because I settled for less than usual. But that's okay, it could be worse. Let's get on over to that giant tuna. Oh my god. Please let this little offspring, our Skippy Jr., be some kind of athletic champion. Come on, little man. Come on, guy. You can do it. Get that cute little kangaroo butt of yours in a gear. Just resist your heritage. I've got to check the map here to see where the food is. Oh, my God, guys. Thank God we've got a few supplies, because looks like we're going to be gnawing through most of them to get through the freaking map over to Shibuya Station. All right, come on. Let's do it. Come on. Go, 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 go. Our little athlete. There you go, Greg. Come on. Actually, I'm not gonna mark here. I'm going to just push through this portion of the map as quickly as possible, because we've got 5 years. 5 years to get to the other end of this map, which is insane! Oh my god. Seriously, like, I sometimes jog to Shibuya, and it certainly doesn't take 5 years to get from one end of the place to the other. If I'm jogging and, you know, circling around the busy Hachiko Crossing area, it'd probably take me about, how long? Probably take me about 30 minutes at a solid jog to get from Yoyogi Park to the Shibuya suburbs as described in our map here. Yeah. This map, I don't know what the hell's going on here. Maybe the poison in the air is causing all these animals to age incredibly quickly. But yeah, I certainly don't put, you know, age 5 years while going from one end of frickin' Doganzaka to the other. Come on, let's go, watch the grass, especially at night. Damn it, why can't we get ourselves a necklace, a little bit of bling that has some headlights on it? That would be much appreciated right about now. Come on, Mr. Kangaroo! Get your stamina up, boy! Got a lot of work ahead of ya! No time to waste! Actually, I shouldn't be bothering to mark here either, should I? Because the... Oh, man, again? Alright, what else have we got there? Oh, wrong button. I've got to start defeating animals as well, don't I, guys? Ah, this challenge system is driving me crazy! Crazy in love for you. Crazy in love for you. Let's reduce toxicity, because that's getting a bit scary. And fill our hunger, because we've got no food, it seems. There we go. Oh, and go back and get that peasant with it. Yay, bottled water. Much better than what we just consumed. Frickin' beagle, watch yourself. Beagle, beagle. Actually, we've got to kill ourselves some animals, so you're the first one that's going to be frickin' pawned by Skippy Junior Junior. Man, why don't they do that, Skippy Junior Junior? Oh, they go the third, don't they, when they're naming kids? They go Junior, and then, like, the second? Oh, no, then the third, yeah, the third. So, my apologies, Skippy. You are Skippy the third. Oh my god, and you have got to get laid, son. We have 3 years left to get giant tuna, and we've got to destroy 20 animals on the way. This is not happening. This is rough. Game, what are you doing making me traverse the entire freaking map in one playthrough? Getting laid twice in 10 years. This is not happening. Sorry, guys, but you gotta take one for the team. Gotta take one. I gotta kill some of you guys because we are running out of time. Like it's nobody's business. And we're really gotta get laid here as well. Because all the other zones, all their lairs are a long way away from the kittle points. Desperation is settling in, guys. Come on, bro. Oh, shit. Fudge me and a popsicle in the eye. Damn it. He called in his mates, but I guess that gives us more to kill. Just watch our life. Don't let the life disappear. Kill that guy that's hiding in that grass. He is not getting a freaking stealth kill on me. Like so many of his freaking carnivore mates have. There we go. Golden Retriever, you're going down. If I can reach you? No? Okay, apparently I can't get over those bars. Oh, a horsey. Hello, horsey. Frickin' up, get the guy that's calling in reinforcements! Yes, get him! Kick his ass! Kick his ass! Kick his ass! Get him! Did I get it? Did I stop him? Oh, thank God I knocked the cell phone out of his hand. He couldn't call in his reinforcements. Hallelujah, Lord! Oh, my God. Oh, my... this is... Fuck! We're not gonna make it to the giant churner in the air. Oh, I hate you, game! You're so mean! Yeah, you! Come with me! Oh, well, at least we can get laid twice, I guess. Oh, man! That is rough! Stupid game! Being so mean to me. Making me compromise my life choices. Just so I can find some tuna. snap. We ain't getting another. We're not even gonna freaking. Why is that still not complete? Man. Oh well. At least in the next challenge bracket, which will be the one that unlocks us the boxing gloves, thankfully. I think we can do it. We've got 15 years. We've got from year 31 to 45 to mark 8 times, intake 3,000 calories, and find the buffalo pardon me, the Buffalo Boss. Completely doable, I think, gang. Come on, I need to kick the ass of four more animals in like 3 seconds. Anyone around here with a death wish? No? Oh. Damn it. That means we're not going to be able to ever unlock our tuxedo. Damn it, game. Don't make me literally go from one end of the map to the other in 10 years, you bastard. Ah, I gotta get out of this district. It's covered in smog. Ah, fine. At least it seems to have already killed all of the predators in the area. Yeah, shut up. Fail. You're the one that fails, game, for God's sakes. Hey, I've done a real magnificent job. Ask any one of the Jade Warriors. They know how hard I just tried at that challenge. It's not my fault, you suck ass. Oh, crap. Damn it. Every time you change generations, things get harder and harder and harder. So there's going to be a ton of food here, it seems. But it's all going to be poisoned. Ugh. The Yokozuna has appeared in Shibuya suburbs. Interesting. Yokozuna. I don't really know what that is. One quick look here. Yeah, that's it. Boxing gloves. Alright. We can do it, guys. We can do it. We're going to get those boxing gloves. And they're going to fit so snugly. They're going to be the best boxing gloves anyone has ever seen. So, let's do this. 8 times, 3,000 calories. Alright, the main concern for this playthrough, I think, guys, is going to be the toxicity level. Keeping that down is going to be rough. So, what we'll do is... stupid beagle. We'll mark the district, and we'll try and move through it quickly before we reach a toxicity of 100. But we've got ourselves a ton of items, so we should be good. Should be good. Good for reducing toxicity. Let's just see if we can get the hell out of this zone. Come on, quickly, piddle, piddle! You're in a race here, man, against the clock. If you don't stop piddling soon, you're gonna die. Oh shit, we're at max items, which is grand, because we're just about to use one. Slightly. Yes, pet medicines. Use! Yay, there we go. 10%. At least it stops our... Oh, that was luck and a half. Holy snap! Oh, thank God I was ready for that evade. Holy shiver my timbers. Alright, let's keep marking. We've got to reach... Seriously? Seriously? The freaking smug's following me? You suck, game. This game has it out for me. Ugh. Fine. Seeing as you're going to be a bitch, let's just rock the toxicity at 100%. Huh? What's going on? I'm totally eating a poison plant right now, but... okay, my life is decreasing. Ah, frickin'. Oh, it was a rabbit. Sorry, rabbit! Sorry! Oh, that was mean. Alright. Alright, we're gonna have to use an item post-haste because we're about to die. Get rid of fleas. Fills hunger gauge and reduces toxicity. Let's do it. By 25. That's good. Good stuff. Anything that gets that life back up, because we are running out. Alright, food! I know there's food around here somewhere! Who's holding out on me? Come on, food! Where are you at? Where you at, food? Oh! Or presents. Presents is also good. Oh! Because we're gonna be freaking chewing through them with all this freaking toxicity. Come on! Clear up! It's daytime! Come on, doesn't... The heat, the sun, cause freaking all the smog to rise up and... Oh, just a nice gust of wind to clear the streets of all this freaking smog would be greatly appreciated. Alright, we've got the primo pet food. Greatly. We've got a few items now that reduces toxicity greatly, but let's see if we can use up the slightly stuff first. 10% is good. Oh, I've got fleas, so there's an excuse to use a flea shampoo. Beautiful. There we go. We're laughing. And is that poison plant there? Is that a poison plant? You're in my way, piggy. Yeah, okay. Yes, it is. It's a poison plant. Not good for a growing Skippy the Third like me. Skippy, Skippy, Skippy the Oh my god. It has been 25 odd years since I watched it, so give me a break, guys. It's not my fault I can't remember the song. Oh shit, why is there two of them calling for reinforcements at once? Seriously? Ah, and I'm getting poisoned here. Shit. Alright, greatly it is. Oh no, that's slightly. Alright, greatly. Yes, get that water in here. Alright, there we go. Ah. Oh shit! No, 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 no! No, 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 no! No, 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 no! No, 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 come on, boy! Come on! Come on, Skippy! Come on, Junior! Let's get the fuck out of here! Come on, boy! Come on, boy! Hide! Hide in the grass! Hide in the grass! Please let that be enough! Because it's a dead end up here! We established that in the last episode. Holy shit. Oh, they can still see us. They can still see us. Can I just cower in this corner? Yeah, there we go. There we go. They're having trouble pathfinding up here. Yes! Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, crap. Ah, do we have anything to increase life? Holy. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ah, how much life? All of it? All of it? All of it? Oh, bless you. Oh, bless you. Freaking awesome item of greatness. Oh, bless you, sir. Oh, if you were a living entity, I'd give you a hug. Ah, oh, freaking hyena. Oh, I hate all of you and your moms. Ah, oh, freaking hyenas. Damn you. Oh, guys, that was the closest call I think we've had yet in this game. That was crazy. Oh my god, I can't believe that just went down. Bless that item, because yeah, we took 15 damage to our health from that. Oh, that was a close call. That was definitely close. But Jamal and Jabu. Alright. Oh, more predators. You are dying before you have a chance to call in reinforcements. Hell, I'm so pro at this, I've even got time to open presents mid-battle. I only need one foot to kick your ass. The other foot can be flipping through a freaking magazine. Ha! How's that for a slap to your face? And a Charlie's your uncle. Huh? Yeah. You better believe it. Oh, shit. Where is the food around here? I know you want them to make the game more challenging, you know. Crispies, the guys that made the game. I know you want to make it more challenging. The longer you play the game, the more generations that you progress. But, come on, I need some food, mate. I need food. You can't just not give any food at all. Like, you gotta give me some. Oh my god. All right, we're gonna have to head back to Golgonzaka. Because we're got nothing. There is nothing here for us. Ah. And all the food and dog and duck is poison. We're gonna be chewing through our items like crazy. Oh shit, watch the life, watch the life. Concentrate, concentrate, there we go. Oh, the hunger, the hunger. Oh, game, 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 game. I can only look at so many statistics at once, guys. We've got the freaking danger gauge, we've got the life, the hunger, the toxicity, the life, the challenge requirements, the mini map. Oh my god! Where do you want me to look, game? Alright, let's see. Anything to increase hunger. Alright, greatly. Gonna have to scoff down on a bottled water. There we go. And just hide, I guess. Until whatever the hell saw me gives up. Because of something up there on the roof? Something on the roof is seeing me? Or, I don't know. There we go, he's dead. The pigs? Oh, the pigs! The pigs are revolting! Oh shit! Once again, we find ourselves in a rather stinky predicament, guys! Oh shit! No! Our freaking Skippy the Third, he's dead! From a freaking pig! A pig killed us, guys! What the hell is going on in this kingdom of crazy freaking animals? Oh, I'm getting freaking flying pigs. There's literally flying pigs in this game, guys. And they're kicking my ass six ways of Sunday. Oh, why? Why are there flying pigs? That is not to freaking code. That is not realistic at all. Oh, my god, this game is freaking bonkers. Oh my god, I love it. Flying pigs. Oh, fantastic. Oh, damn. Hey, mate, did you see that? I totally kicked your bros in a freaking flock of flying pigs. Oh, fantastic. Alright, oh shit. I should put some duds on before I go into any more heated battle, shouldn't I, guys? Headlamp would help. Here we go. The information is apparently very important to the items because, you know, ala the backpack we were wearing, we had a hell of a lot more storage space, didn't we, guys? So here we go. Information, there's a face only a mother could love. A surprising hit at parties, though. Okay. Improves visibility at night. It's not nighttime. And adds a small defense bonus. All right. Let's go with the Hayotoko mask. Hopefully it'll scare off some of our mates. And to chuck on our backside. Let's see here. Ragged jacket. Cheap. It's the most trite animal jacket left in existence. A raincoat, which is when it's raining out, raises stamina just a bit. Okay, interesting. And a cozy sweater. It's really cozy. And it allows us to carry 15 items. All right. Let's put our pack back on because we need the space. We are chewing through these items like crazy game. Oh, shit. This is not good. I do not have energy to waste on you guys. God damn it. Can you go harass a lion or something? I'm sure he'll be happy to accommodate the frickin' battle lust. Jesus. Leave us herbivores in peace. I swear, I'm gonna petition the Animal Kingdom government that all hyenas should be kept at least 500 meters from any herbivore. Frickin' any living herbivore, anyway. He wasn't calling for reinforcements. I didn't see a freaking circle above his head. God damn it, game. Oh, we're nearly dead. No, I'm not dying by a hyena. I have to die by something much more stupid and unreasonable. Like a freaking cow. In our last playthrough. God damn, that was hilarious. We died by a cow. All right, let's get that caution rating down. Goodbye, caution. Goodbye. Ah, yeah, get yourself down to 0%, son. Excellent. Alright, come on, 0%. You're nearly there. You can do it. Come on, fella. Yay. And as soon as we hit caution zero, our toxicity starts increasing. God damn it. Stupid game. Alright, let's do it. Hide in the grass. And hide in the grass. And he's not asleep. He's dead. Alright. Any food? Hey, pig! Have you seen any food? You've got one hell of a snout on you, don't you? Can't you locate some grub for me? I'd appreciate it. I can give you something in return. Whoa! Oh, you're a nice female, too. Do you want to get down and funky with me? No? Here I was going to settle for you, you average female, and no. Apparently I'm not good enough for you. Frickin' high standards. These women of today, they all want their Tom Cruises and Brad Pitts. But an average Joe like me will not suffice. I cannot survive. I will never have any adorable, cute offspring of my own in this freaking economy. The only way a person like me can get lucky if I have myself my own menagerie, my own botanical gardens of food. All right, slightly, greatly, I guess. Good. Yeah, fill that hunger up. Yeah, son. That means good things for the rest of my life. Like living. Come on! Shit, my danger's at 100%, but I'm not seeing anyone on the map chasing me! Oh, you suck! Don't surprise me like that from the ground! Oh, how did he get a call out when I'm uppercutting him in the jaw? Holy shit. Whole kingdom full of them. Ugh. Give me something good. Some good news. Yeah, Primo Pest pet food is awesome. Oh, more presents. Yes, please. Discounted pet food. Even better. Ah, beagles on the roof. Watch the grass. Come on. Fill up stamina bar. Whoa, shit. No, this is really bad. And I'm not settling for... Oh, bears. Bears. Oh, shit. Many bears. Many bears. Oh, oh, he's bigger than the average bear. Oh, shit. Promo pet food is good, though. Thank you for the promo pet food. And now can... Oh, my God. It's another bear. What is this? A bear convention? Oh, can't you guys be satisfied by eating a mouthful of beagle? I hate those guys. I'll freaking even make it worth your while. I'll give you, I'll freaking lead them to you. I'll freaking like totally drag them in your direction and you can kick their asses as you please. Oh, I guess there's no negotiating with a big ass furry beast. Yeah, I should know I'm one of them. Look at that hair. Damn, I'm a hairy bastard. Alright, what do we got going on here? I don't even know anymore. What am I doing with my challenge list? I'm so lost. Okay, mark two more times. Intake a hell of a lot more calories, which is going to be hard. The freaking bears populating the entirety of the one zone that has food. Find the buffalo boss in the Shibuya woods. Ah, that's where we just were, though. I didn't see no buffalo boss. No Buffalo Bill. Oh, how many years we got left? We're running out of time, and I'm starting to worry. I want those boxing gloves, gang. If I can't have those boxing gloves, no one will. I swear to you, no one shall have them. If not myself. Freaking golden retrievers. Actually, I shouldn't be so rough on the golden retrievers. They don't tend to attack me when I don't desire them to. Alright, we're going to get into Dogenzaka, guys. We're going to try and totally stealth our way around these bears, because they're rough. They're smarter than the average bear, and we only have ourselves a couple more years. We've got 4 more years to eat. 2,500 calories. Oh, crap. This is not going to happen. Holy snap, this game is rough. Yeah. As you guys can tell, I'm sure, I'm definitely getting better at the gameplay elements. I know that how to handle myself, how to survive in the thick of battle. Oh, you're a prime female. Oh. Okay, guys. If we can't complete our first objective, which is to totally get those boxing gloves, hell be damned if we don't get ourselves a piece of that fine. Oh, shit. That fine prime kangaroo booty. Oh shit, god damn it. And the kangaroos are so freaking big, they won't. What are you? I freaking hate you. Oh, golden retriever. Sorry, I keep taking my aggression out on the freaking poor golden retrievers. Alright, where's some more food? There's supposed to be a lot more food in this zone, isn't there? What, no food? What the hell? What? Oh, gosh darn it, game. What are you doing to me? I swear that was a full food freaking bar, barely. What, 20 minutes ago? Freaking beagles. Shut up, boy. Remind me, if I ever get a pet dog again, not to get a beagle. Are they really that noisy in real life? That's freaking noisy, I can tell you right now. All right, now let's look for this buffalo. See if we can say hello. Slap him some skin. You hiding up this end of the map, mate? No? Alright, fine. Let's look in the other direction. Oh, man. You gotta work with me, game. You gotta give me at least a little food if you want me to traverse the entirety of the map. You gotta at least, you know, make food available if you want me to digest 3,000 calories. And you just gotta give me more time if you want me to frickin' mate twice in 10 years. Come on, game. Be reasonable. Be reasonable. I'm a reasonable individual. I don't ask too much of you. Oh, I guess I am. I'm being very unreasonable, actually. A plant! I see a plant! I see food! And I can't get to it. Are you kidding me? Just wait. Can I get up here and jump over? Oh, there you go. Now food is easily perishable in the blistering heat. Fantastic. And the toxicity's going up. And there's predators everywhere. And there goes. I did not complete a single challenge. How did I not freaking mark 8 times? I swear I marked freaking 12 times, didn't I? What are you doing to me, game? Shit. I guess this will not be a successful challenge today, guys. It's not a successful pawnage of the list of challenges. But this will be the final noobing, guys. This is the final noobing. This is the last time I shall not pawn the challenges. I shall not pawn this game. This is it. So enjoy the last time you see me noob it up, because from here on out, we are going elite, friends. We are gonna freaking pawn this like a boss. See, combat's down, stealth is down, evading is down. The only thing that's not down is getting a decent freaking challenge list. All right, defeat 30 animals, mark 10 times. All right, I'm gonna get myself laid first, so we can change generations, and then let's see what the food situation is like. Yeah, fine. Seeing as everything else is going to shit, the smog's rolling in, that'll just be the perfect cover I need, so I don't have to look at your desperate face while we get down and funky. It just totally fits our freaking bad luck for this episode. Oh, and I've even got fleas. Fantastic. At least we're mating before we hit 100% toxicity. Gotta look on the bright side of life, guys. Always look on the bright side of life. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Always look on the bright side of life. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. When life is looking shit, make the most of it. When you're playing Tokyo Jungle, watch the grass so you don't die all suddenly, and you will have a much longer playthrough. Oh, always look on the bright side of life. Doo-doo, 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 doo-doo. Always look on the bright side of life. Doo-doo, 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 doo-doo. Don't do any drugs, because if you do, your toxicity will hit max very quickly. Because even just breathing through your lungs causes you to die like a drug addict from overdosing on illegal narcotics. And always look on the bright side of life. Oh! Oh, I see flowers! I see flowers! Hell yeah! Just what I've been looking for to brighten up my apartment. Just a little bit of color, guys. That's all we need. And our model home will be complete. What's the bet? There's like 26 gorillas guarding it. With Uzis, some kind of, you know, gun. It's gonna kick my ass. I can't even make out what the hell that animal is, so I'm just gonna sneak past it. Didn't I see flowers? That looks like a rotten tomato. Oh my god, that takes me back. Ah, shit, now the toxicity is killing me. Where were those flowers I saw? I totally saw nice flowers. Are you nice flowers? No, you're poison flowers. Are you poison flowers? You're poison flowers. Ah. All right, what do we got? We need to reduce our toxicity. Stamina, hunger gauge, toxicity reduced, bills, raises. Slightly. Let's go with the slightly. There we go. And apparently this is a dead end. Oh, game. And I can't ride the Yamanote. Why can I? Because you guys are a bunch of freaking racists. Ah, crap. This game, she's boiling my blood today, guys. I swear, we're going... Ah, why did I do that? There we go. Predatorial nature of those animals confirmed. Shite. All right, come on. Come on, Skip. Start. Oh, we're at max toxicity again, aren't we? Slightly, yep, sure. Toxicity's down 10. Oh, please. I want to die in the jaws of a moo cow like I did last time. I don't want to die from freaking toxicity. That is like the most noobish way to die. Come on, Skip. What are you? I think you're Skippy the Fourth. Or VI. That's the way we should say it now. Skippy VI. Almost sounds like some kind of doctor. What's that? Are you a... Oh, shit. Oh, you guys are just all kinds of nice, aren't you? Oh, you're busy fighting each other. Do you mind if I just sneak past quickly and piddle here? You guys, don't let me get in the way between you two. Oh, holy crap, that was close. Holy crap. All right, thank God they didn't mind me stepping in between their little feud there. Because that could have turned ugly very quickly. Why is everything poisoned? Is there no way to reduce freaking... I'm not like 50% herbivore and 50% predator, am I? Oh shit, they're attacking me. Oh shit, I pissed off all the... There! I'm sorry, dearest one! I'm sorry... I'm lying! Oh shit, he saw me and... Oh my god, everything's going to hell in a handbasket. Alright, let's... These are not happy tears. These are tears of desperation. Ah, everything's freaking poisoned. Oh, these deers are totally flanking me. Everyone's calling in reinforcements. Ah, I'm evading something. There's crocodiles here. Oh my god, it's a freaking disco. Everyone get down and funky. Holy shit, this is insane. My toxicity maxed out again. No. But, oh, buffalo, hey, you're not the buffalo bus from last challenge requirements, are you? Oh, shit, crocodiles everywhere. Can you guys just piss off and leave me alone? Just let me die in peace of old age. It'd be greatly appreciated. Oh, toxicity at 95%. What am I supposed to do? I'm going to have to look it up. There's got to be something I'm missing, guys. There's got to be a way to stop all this freaking toxicity from choking my lungs. Because there goes my bro. There goes Skippy. IV positive. And we're on to Skippy the Fifth now. And he's our slightly hopeless son of Skippy the Third. He doesn't know really how to get through in life. And we've lost ourselves our handy backpack, so we can't carry any additional supplies. Alright, seeing as we're going to hell in a handbasket, we might as well chuck the Demon Lord plush on our shoulders. And he can ride us there in style, can't you, mate? Alright, let's do this. Let's do this, guys. We're going to hell. Woo! Hold on to your hats, because it's going to be a wild ride. Hell yeah, son. You, come on. Are you going to be the one that takes me to hell? Come on. Is that all you got? What about you? Are you going to take me to hell? Oh, you tried, but you failed like a freaking wiener. Yeah, I called you a wiener dog. You ain't a lion. Ha! Come on. Come on. You going to get me? Look at me. I'm totally just taunting you. I'm teabagging you. I'm teabagging you. Ooh, teabag. Oh, present. Oh, shit. There goes my life. I'm not going to go out, willingly. I'm going to go down fighting. All right, fills hunger gauge and reduces toxicity greatly. Let's do this. Down you go, toxicity. And in you come, stamina jerky. Oh, more presents. Come on. Ah, oh, item max is... Oh, my God. I'm talking in tongues. I'm so super pumped right now. All right, give me that stamina boost. Because once we die, pretty much all these items are gone anyway. What, there's nothing else here? Where? I swear to you, I haven't seen a plant. I've seen what? We've seen three poisoned plants in the last freaking four zones. Yeah! Oh, kick your ass. Come on. No one's gonna touch me. I ain't going to hell just yet. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's a plant, but it's freaking poison. Damn, you cannot survive in this game without using items to your advantage. Ha! Like a rat race. only with lions and tigers and moo cows. Hey, look! I just found myself an unpoisoned plant! No! Oh, I just found an unpoisoned plant! You ain't taking me alive! You ain't taking me alive, copper! That unpoisoned plant is mine, bitch! Oh! Oh! Kicked your ass, tiger! Oh, shit! Bring it, son! Come on! No! I just found fresh plants! No! Oh my god, that was fantastic! That was the best playthrough yet, I think, guys. That was fan-freaking-tastic. I had a hell of a lot of fun. Yes, we had problems with those challenges, but don't worry. The next animal we try out, we're totally going to pawn every single challenge. And the game, I'm gonna take it aside and have a talk to it after I wrap things up and tell him next time. He better be more kind to me, because it's not just me he's being kind to, it's you guys too. I hope you guys had a hell of a lot of fun today. I know I did. That's a pretty decent score. Thank you very much for tuning in. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the episode, and if you made it this far, holy crap, yeah, please leave a like. If you leave a like, I get an idea of how many people actually watch the entirety of this episode, because this is by far the longest episode I've uploaded yet to the channel, and I'm so happy it's going to be as long as it is, because I had a lot of fun, guys. And please leave a comment, let me know what you thought of the episode, how crazy, batshit crazy it was, even your favorite moment. I'd love to know. There was quite a few key awesomeness displays of awesomeness in this episode. But until next time, as always, thank you very much for watching once again, and お時間もお楽しみに。じゃあね、気をつけて。また明日ね。バイバイ。バイバイ。バイ。バイ。